Hello, this is the lecture number 9 for the chapter application of derivative, and we are starting with the question number 24 of exercise 6.3. Now you have to find the equation of tangent and normal to this curve at this point, and this is, you know, that the equation of the hyperbola is there. So you simply differentiate it. 2x upon a square minus 2y d by dx upon b square is equal to 0. So d by dx will be equal to minus 2x upon a square into b square upon 2y. And because you have to find the slope tangent at the point x naught, y naught, so replace x and y as at x naught and y naught. This is the equation of the slope of the tangent. Now the equation of tangent will be y minus y naught is equal to slope x minus x1. The slope is this. Point is x1 and x naught and y naught. So you cross multiply it and arrange, taking the x b square, x naught square to the left hand side, a square y naught square in the left hand side, and these two term to the right hand side. Now divide the whole equation by a square b square. This is the main term. Divide the whole equation by a square b square. So you're getting x naught square upon a square, y naught square upon b square. This will be x naught upon a square, y naught upon b square. And we know that this is equal to 1. It is given that it is equal to 1 because it is x square y square. So x naught y naught will satisfy this equation. So this is also represent the equation of the curve. So x naught square upon a square minus y naught square upon b square will be equal to 1. This is the main stuff here which you have to replace. Now in question number 25, it is given that the slope of the tangent as equation to the, or rather it is parallel to a given line, and you have to find the slope. So the curve is y is equal to under root 3x minus 2, and d by dx you simply find it because you have to always find the slope of the tangent. 1 upon 2 under root 2x, 3x minus 2 into 3, which is the slope of the tangent at the point x1, y1 you have to find. So replace x by x1, and the slope of the line is tangent is parallel to a given line, and the given line is 4x minus 2y plus 5 equal to 0, whose slope is minus a upon b, which is coming out to be 2. Now because these are parallel, or rather this is the equation of the tangent, so the slope of the tangent will be equal to the slope of the tangent to this line, which is both are equal. So replace, equate them. By equating them, you are getting the value of x1 as 41 upon 48. And replace this value of x1 in the original equation or the curve, you will get y1. So the equation of tangent will be y minus y1 is equal to 2x minus x1. Simplify this. I have put it directly. x1, y, it is 41 upon 48. Y1, you can easily solve it and replace in the equation of tangent. You will get the equation of the tangent. Now in question number 26, the curve is given as 4x plus 3 cos x, and you'll find the slope of the tangent at the point x is equal to 0. So simply find d by dx, which is equal to 4 plus, minus 3 sin x. It is a derivative of the given curve, which is 4x plus 3 cos x. Now at x is equal to 0, replace x by 0, cos x 0. So it is coming out to be 3. The slope of the tangent at x is equal to 0 is 3, which is the slope of the tangent. And the slope of the normal will be the negative reciprocal of this. The slope of the normal will be negative reciprocal of the slope of the tangent. Now in question number 27, the curve is given and the line is given. Now the curve is y square is equal to 4x. You simply differentiate to obtain the slope of the tangent, which is 2y d by dx is equal to 4. D by dx is equal to 2 upon y. And at x1, y1, it will be 2 upon y1, which is the slope of the tangent. And the slope of the line is x minus y minus 1 will be equal to minus a upon b, which is coming out to be 1. And because it is given that the tangent is this equation, therefore these slopes will be equal to each other. So 2 upon y1 is equal to 1. So you are getting y1 as 2. And when you replace this y1 by putting in the original equation or this given equation, that is x minus y is equal to minus 1, you will get the x coordinate, and the required point will be 1 and 2. 1 and 2 is the, at this point, the tangent to the curve is equal to this line. So it means it is given that this is the tangent of the curve. So this is the completion of this exercise based on the tangents and normals, and it is a long exercise and the very good concepts are there in this exercise of tangent and normal, where we have discussed the slope of the x-axis is 0 and slope of the y-axis is not defined. The slope of the curve is obtained or the slope of the tangent to the curve is obtained by differentiating the curve at the given point, and the slope of the normal is perpendicular to the tangent, which will be the negative reciprocal of the given line. And we have done the equation of the tangent and the equation of the normal. So this is the completion of the exercise tangent and normal, which is 6.3. Now the next topic is somewhat easy topic, which is error and approximation. In this, you have to find the approximate value of the given expression by using the differentiation. Now we know that the derivative of the function fx is equal to fx plus h minus fx upon h, where limit x goes to 0. Now when you put this to the left hand side, it will be f dash x minus fx plus minus fx upon h, which is sufficiently small when h is very, very small. When h is very, very small, this expression will be very, very small. So when h is sufficiently small, then we take this f x plus h minus fx as nearly equal to f dash x, means we can nearly take it equal to f dash x, this value. So by equating them, we are getting as f x plus h is equal to h f dash x plus fx. When h is very, very small, then the expression is nearly equal to f dash x, means this is equal to this. When you put this equal to f dash x by limiting very, very small, then this f dash x will be equal to this. You put this equal to h f dash x is equal to f x plus h minus f x. We are getting this expression. Now by using this expression, we can easily find the approximate value of the given expressions. Now as this, you have to find the value of under root 25 minus 3 by using the differentiation, Now what you have to do in these types of question, you have to simply find the value of x and h and f dash x and fx. Now because you have to find the value of a square root of some expression, so you let fx is equal to root x, because you have to find the square root of some number. So you let fx is equal to root x. So always you have to let the function fx root x. If it is equal to cube root, then you have to find the fx is equal to cube root of x. Now we have let fx is equal to root x, so we need the derivative of this function f dash x. To find the derivative of this function, 1 upon 2 root x will be there. Now for root 25.3, you have to break in such a way that there is a perfect square root, nearest perfect square root of 25.3. So the nearest square root of this will be 25 plus 0.3. So you write in the form x plus h. Because we need, by to use this formula, we need the value of x, we need the value of h, we need the value of f dash x, we need the value of fx. So fx we have let as equal to root x, and by breaking this 25.3 as 25 plus 0.3, we have obtained the value of x as 25 and h as 0.3. Now replace this value in this formula. So fx plus h is equal to fx plus h f dash x. So x is 25, h is 0.3, fx is root x, h is 0.3, derivative of fx is 1 upon 2 root x. Replace the value of x as 25, x as 25, and this will be added as 25.3, and f 25.3 will be root 25.3. Which you have to find in the left hand side. You will always get the value you have to find. So root 25 will be equal to 5. So 0.3 upon 10 will be equal to 0.03. So 5 plus 0.03 is the square root of this number. So by using this derivative, we are able to find the approximate value of this. Similarly here, root 49.5 you have to find, and you can break like this: 45 plus 0.5. F you have to break in the form x plus h. X will be equal to 49 and h will be equal to 0.5. And because you have to find the square root of some number, so again you have to let fx is equal to root x. And the derivative of root x will be 1 upon 2 root x. Replace in this formula. Derivative we have f dash x we know, fx we know, h we have 0.5, f dash x we have 1 upon root x. Replace the value always in the left hand side. It will be 49.5 like this. f x plus h, we have used this formula, f x plus h like this. And f x is root 49, h f dash x will be this. This is f x plus h in the left hand side. F x plus h, f x plus h dash x. So it will be root x, 1 upon 2 root x will be like this. Wrong is here. F x plus h, 49.5 and square root of 49.5 as we have done it here. So root 49 is 9, 1 upon 2 root 49 will be 7. Simplify this term and add 2 to the 7, which will be 7.036. So you have to break this expression like this so that you can easily find the square root of that number. You can have a good command over this and by doing many questions. Now you have to find the square root of 0.6. Now see it very carefully how you have to break. Now 0.06 you can write 0.06, 0.6 you can write 0.06, and the nearest square root of 0.060 will be equal to 0.64, and you have to subtract minus 0.4. So 0.64 minus 0.04 will be equal to 0.6. This is the breaking of this. This is the main thing. So the x here is 0.64. H is minus 0.04. See it carefully, minus. H is minus 0.04. So fx plus h, we have bracketed out. And fx, you have to again let it equal to root x. The derivative will be 1 upon 2 root x. 1 upon 2 root x, again using the same formula, fx plus h is equal to fx plus h f dash x. Now x is 0.64, h is minus 0.04. When you subtract it, it will be 0.6, and f 0.6 will be equal to root 0.6. In the left hand side, you always get this because you are finding the value of this. In the right hand side, fx is root x, h is minus 0.04, f dash x is 1 upon 2 root x. Replace the value of x as 0.64. Here also 0.64, the square root of 0.64 is 0.8, square root of 0.64 is 0.8. Simplify this expression, we are getting as 0.025 minus, and when you subtract this from 8, you are getting 0.775, which is the square root of 0.6, which is the square root of 0.6, like this. Main thing is here, h is negative here, h is negative here. Okay, we'll discuss the remaining question in the next lecture. Thank you.